Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Richard Wood with Z News.
We are live, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you once again for joining us for this, the 8th podcast edition of Z News, which is a compendium of information and business, finance, economics and social and political issues worldwide, reaching over 10,000 subscribers worldwide. Parts of our publication are picked up by 60 different websites weekly, exposing our ideas to over 10 million investors a week. It is Wednesday, the second day of February 2011. Coming up on the show today, Wall Street cuts Treasury holdings and Fed balance sheet won't balance for some time to come. We believe there is a distinct possibility that the US Treasury has little or no gold left. We know for sure that bars that look and feel like gold are in Fort Knox, but we do not know if they are gold-covered tungsten bars or who they belong to. There could be hundreds of billions of dollars of bogus gold bars floating around the world. John Williams, taking into account real inflation since 1980, when gold was $850 an ounce, says gold should be selling at $7,700 an ounce. We believe silver should already be selling at over $100 an ounce. These figures will become reality over the next several years as the elitist suppression of gold and silver prices nears its end. Last June, we reported that subscribers had a very difficult time getting delivery of gold from their accounts in Switzerland. We do not know how widespread this is, but if you hold gold and silver in Swiss banks, you should be concerned. We also advise that if you move your assets out of the country, you had best be prepared to live with them. We lived in Geneva in Zurich for 3 years, worked and went to university there, and the Swiss are simply financial parasites set up by world elitists so that they could all keep their assets safe. That is why the Swiss have had no wars for over 150 years. That in mind, there is no question that major Western banks control Europe and the US and are influential worldwide. It could be via such control that investors who have accounts in these banks could have their gold and silver frozen in the future. If that happens, it will be because the gold and silver has already been sold or leased and you will be offered currency in place of your holdings. Having lived there for some time and watching the antics for the Swiss for more than 20 years, we wouldn't trust them any further than we could kick them. We have lots of experience yet to relay. All banks today lie about everything. Thus, anything goes. They own the regulators and the governments. They are all carrying two sets of books. The entire world banking system is bogus. In order to avoid criminal charges, the banks will pay in currency. The Chinese current account balance is now $2.85 trillion in various currencies. Thus, it is no surprise that they are buying gold, silver, commodities, and anything priced reasonably. That is why every time gold and silver and commodities are knocked down, they rise right up again. This war, as we have pointed out for the last 2 years, is gold versus currencies, particularly versus the dollar. The battle for the paramount world reserve currency has already been won by gold. The world just doesn't know it yet. Great pressure could be brought to bear on behalf of gold and silver prices if the US and European public were to get involved. Their participation has been lackluster. The gold and silver markets have been forced into another consolidation, which makes the possibility of a deeper correction less likely. Eventually, a reserve currency or a world index of currencies has to be backed by gold. Today, gold can rise or fall $20 and silver 1 cent. In the future, next we will see gold move $50 either way and silver $2 or $3. In silver, there is a giant naked short position and over 30 class action lawsuits, one of which is RICO. In addition, the silver market is deeply short of silver for delivery. That means $30 should be easy. There is massive pressure to the upside, as there is in gold. In addition, almost every time we look, both at gold and silver are in backwardization. That is, when the spot month trades higher than the active outside month, which is bullish. There is no doubt that now is an exceptional time to buy both gold and silver. The public in the US and Europe are not really in the market as yet. At some point they will arrive, triggered perhaps by $2,000 or $3,000 gold, or perhaps $60 or $70 silver. We don't know what the trigger will be, but it is coming. When they arrive, it will be like the thunder and lightning to the upside, and there will be no stopping it. Pensions and Investment Magazine says Newt Gingrich is pushing for legislation to allow bankrupt states to file bankruptcy, and in that process, renege on pension and other benefit obligations to state workers. It also means that those holding municipal bonds would be wiped out. This is a neocon dream, backed by the same trash that accompanied the last moron we had for president, whose name will not pass our lips. This is nothing more nor less than a frontal attack against the average American to put them in an economic and financial position from which they have no leverage and will be forced to accept world government. It just goes to show you that you could get no assistance from either party because the same elitist groups control both. The chance for elimination of incumbents is past, and we fear what the future reactions will be. And finally today, Wall Street banks are cutting their holdings of treasuries at the fastest pace since 2004 as the world's biggest bond firms bet that the economy will strengthen and demand for high-yielding assets will increase. The 18 primary dealers that trade with the Federal Reserve reported that holdings of US government debt tumbled to a net $2.34 billion on December 29 from $81.3 billion on November 24, the most since June 2009, according to the most recent central bank data. While the stake is the lowest since February, corporate bond and mortgage securities have risen from the lows of the year. Dealers had stocked up on US debt, anticipating demand from customers who wanted to sell the securities to the central bank as part of Fed Chairman Ben Bernanke's plan to buy $800 billion of treasuries. Government bonds lost their allure as stocks rose. Corporate financing conditions eased, expectations for inflation increased, and the dollar strengthened. Quote, "Slowly but surely the economy is getting on stronger footing," said John Fath, who helps manage $2.5 billion at principal at investment firm BTG Pactual in New York, and was the former head of government bond trading at UBS Securities LLC, a primary dealer. Quote, "There are people moving or thinking of moving out of risk-free assets. This is what Bernanke wanted," end quote. Berkshire Hathaway Incorporated, the Omaha, Nebraska-based holding company controlled by billionaire Warren Buffett, and General Electric Company's finance unit, led companies selling a record of $48.5 billion of bonds in the US last week, as relative yield on investment-grade debt shrank to the narrowest since May. Before signing off today, we would like to thank all of our subscribers for making these broadcasts happen. None of this would have been possible without your continued valuable support. Listeners are able to follow me on Twitter at Richard J. Wood or the Zed News feed on our Facebook fan page for the latest stories we are following and to hear my regular radio interviews on the air or online. Also, don't forget to like and also to share these podcasts with your Twitter followers and your Facebook friends. On the program tomorrow, the fall of nations is a real possibility, pain for others, Brazil to wage trade wars, and Ireland hurt with disastrous borrowing policy. Be sure to join us then. I'm Richard Wood, and this has been Zed News, because you can handle the truth.